Hi, this is Kevin Patton with some study tips and tools for your Human Anatomy and Physiology course. Right now I'll focus on some strategies for taking tests and exams. The very first thing to consider is, well, really that you should have some strategies. And what I mean by this are some things that you do before the exam, during the exam, and yes, even after the exam to make yourself more successful in your A&P course. Some before test strategies would include the obvious, and that is to review the material. And what I mean is look over your notes, your flashcards, your concept maps, your concept lists, your highlighted sections of your text, and so on, that you would have been doing during your regular study time in between tests. But of course, what I'm talking about here is a specific and intentional focus for your exam. You also want to make use of any study or review guides that your instructor may have provided for you in the course. And you want to practice. You want to practice as a group, and you want to practice individually with questions that you either think will be on the exam or that might be on the exam. And that could even include questions from previous tests in the course, or maybe even some old tests or exams that the instructor has provided for you. Some instructors, like myself, provide practice exams. Now, I give online practice exams to my students, but your instructor may instead give you some paper practice exams, and if you have those available, by all means use them. Another before test strategy would be to make sure that you're in good test-taking shape. And I mean, you know, be well rested. I know it's a time-honored tradition to stay up all night and cram before an exam, but that really can work against you. Sleep deprivation has been shown to reduce your ability to be successful on an exam. Any benefit you think you're getting from cramming is going to be compensated for the loss of focus that you get from being sleep deprived, so please do not do that. You also want to eat right, and what I mean by well fed here is not just eating enough, but eating the right kinds of foods, eating a balanced meal. If you're eating a lot of sugary junk food right before an exam, you're going to find yourself unfocused and maybe even sleepy, and boy, you don't want to fall asleep during the exam, do you? No. And you also want to relax as much as possible. I think all of us experience at least some level of test anxiety, whether we know it or not. And so anything you can do to relax right before a test, like listening to music, you know, taking a walk down the hall before you come back into the classroom, you know, read the posters on the wall, talk to people, smile at them, look out the window and watch the weather, whatever it is. If there's an aquarium in your department, go look at that, or maybe some models in a case to display case somewhere. Go look at that. Anything to get your mind off that test. And do get some advice, especially from your instructor, because they've been doing this for a while and they know, you know, what has worked and what hasn't worked for students, and they might be able to even give you some focus tips for that particular exam. And there are plenty of books and online resources available that are going to give you far more strategies than I can possibly list right now, and some of those may really click with your personality or your own individual learning style. Now, what are you going to do during the test to make yourself more successful? Well, the first thing I recommend is to skim through the test, and do that before you do anything else. First thing is you want to read directions. Not only the general directions, but the directions for each individual section of the test. And as you do so, you also want to get a feel for the content. You know, what is in the test? Is it the really hard stuff or the not so hard stuff? And I think that might relieve the pressure a little bit, and if nothing else, it'll help you budget your time for the exam a little bit better. Another thing that'll help you budget your time is getting a feel for the types of questions you're going to be asked. Are there going to be essay questions? Are there some multiple choice questions? Are there true and false questions matching? And so on. And again, not only can relieve pressure, it can help you budget your time. And oh, did I say read the directions? Yes, read the directions. So many students skip over that, and it really can clear things up and avoid confusion and, you know, give you a feel for what's going to be on the test. Another during the test strategy would be to analyze the items, and what I mean by that is to use some logic, that is critical thinking skills, as you analyze each item when you answer it. For example, you need to really focus on what actually is being asked. So many of my students fall into what I call the key term trap, where you see a key term in the question and therefore you think you know what the question is all about without reading the question carefully. You think that the question is asking you to somehow describe or define that key term, when in fact that may not exactly be what is being asked. And so be very, very careful that you don't assume and that you really know what is being asked in a particular item. And when you do that, it can help by identifying any qualifying words that are in the item, such as sometimes or always or never. These things can really change the meaning of a question from what you assume it might mean. Another thing that you want to look at is the item asking for normal structure and function or some disease or disorder? Because in A&P classes, we typically focus on normal structure and function, but we do occasionally bring in a disease or disorder in order to help us illustrate normal structure and function. And you could be asked about either one on an exam, so you want to be clear whether you're answering for the normal, healthy version of the body or the diseased version of the body. And you want to be asking yourself, are you being asked something in general or something specific? For example, if I ask an item such as, in cells, does such and such happen? That would be different than, in red blood cells, does such and such happen? Because it could be a little bit unusual in a red blood cell, whereas in cells in general, it would be a completely different answer. And another thing is, you want to right away eliminate whatever is obviously wrong. Now this is true of a multiple choice item where you would be eliminating the choices that clearly cannot be right, and then you focus on and put all your energy into those that could possibly be right. But even in an essay question where, you know, you might sketch out a few possible responses to the essay question, you want to cross out those that do not directly address that specific question. Also during the test, you want to read your items again later on if the time permits. That is, after you're done with the test, then go back over the items and read them again and make sure you understand what's being asked. Sometimes when you come back to a question for the second or third time, it gives you a little bit different perspective, and maybe you see that you didn't answer it correctly. And if you see that you did misread the item, then change it to the correct answer. Also, make sure that you've looked at all the choices if you're given more than one choice on a multiple choice or multiple response or matching item, because a lot of my students, they'll pick the most obvious choice, but maybe there's a better one further down the list. And do go with your gut. I know a moment ago I said to go back and change your answer, but that's only if you know that you've made a mistake. If you go back and second guess yourself, you're probably going to be changing a right answer to a wrong answer, so be very careful about that. Now, after the test, you want to do some test analysis, and I'll give you a link for another presentation I have on how to do test analysis. And you'll want to do a study group discussion where you do sort of a post-mortem exam where you debrief one another. What was your experience on the test? What was my experience on the test? What did we get right? What did we do wrong? And if you find things that, you know, are going wrong for you, then you can find some strategies to fix it. Like if you find that you're having test anxiety, then find ways to fix that. If you're always misreading questions, then find ways to fix that as well. And I don't know any instructor that doesn't invite you to challenge a test item that you think was misleading or misgraded. The worst that can happen is they'll tell you no, but you know, it might be worth the challenge. Of course, you want to do this with respect and in a constructive way. Now, if you want to do some test analysis, here's a URL that'll help you figure out how to do that. And for additional study tips and tools, visit us at theapstudent.org.